for any of these big storms, and even for some of the smaller storms, no one utility has the crews and material they need to respond, because they staff for daily operations, and they have to bring in external resources to try to respond to these events. So that's really one of the main uses of this model, is to help support that decision making. How many crews do we need to bring in? Where should we station them? How many extra poles? How much extra line do we need? Now we have Nate that is heading towards the Gulf Coast. There's uncertainty in the track. We ran some model runs yesterday. We saw one result. Right now, it looks like it's going to be localized to that central Gulf Coast region, kind of Alabama, Florida, Panhandle area. But it really depends on where Nate ends up going and how much intensification it gets. There's a few things we're trying to do. One is to improve how we're capturing the uncertainty. We can really see this with Nate. We don't do the weather forecast. We're ingesting the weather forecast in a sense. So we're trying to develop better ways to represent this uncertainty in that weather forecast in the output of our model. If we're successful in developing these methods to improve the representation of uncertainty and to address these other weather events, then we can help utilities like DTE or Florida Power & Light or any of these utilities that are getting impacted by these events restore power faster and more efficiently.